The Mr. Excel podcast is brought to you by Easy Excel. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today I'm going to show you a cool trick with pivot tables. I have a little pivot table here that's showing me the top five customers. And I have all sorts of report filters up here. So Walmart's the largest customer, but if I choose product, let's say ABC, then Exxon is the largest customer, right? Pivot tables are very powerful. Unfortunately, I'm sorry, they're just ugly. There's no good style that I can choose here that's going to make this, look like a presentation quality type of graphic. So I'm going to go into Insert SmartArt. We'll choose a SmartArt style here. Click OK. And as I build this SmartArt, I'll turn on the text pane. I want to type just dummy values for right now. So customer one, customer two, and the whole goal is for these dummy values to be about the size of your largest value. So General Motors, is typical of something we might see, customer four, and you want to have the right number of shapes, customer five. All right, so once you get that, turn off the text pane. We'll come over here and do a little bit of formatting on the SmartArt. I'll choose a color scheme and then choose a SmartArt style. I'm a big fan of that third 3D style, kind of adds a nice little glow to it. All right, now if you're in Excel 2010, you can use the new Convert to Shapes, but let's assume that you're in Excel 2007. What I want you to do is I want you to click in the SmartArt, but between any shapes. All right, that'll select the whole SmartArt, and then click on one individual shape. Now I've selected that one shape. I now want to press Control A to select all of the shapes, Control C to copy those shapes, and then down here in a blank section of the spreadsheet, Control V to paste an identical copy of the SmartArt, but the difference is this isn't SmartArt anymore, it's shapes. SmartArt is static. You cannot get the values to come from cells. Shapes can be dynamic. Those values can come from cells. So now that I have this selected, I'm going to click in here, and where we have Control C, we'll click inside the customer one and then click on the text box that surrounds that. Now that I've selected that text box, let's see, what cell is it? It is cell A26. So type in the formula bar equal A26 and press enter. Bam, the customer one goes away and you now have the value from A26. I'll do the same thing here. Again, make sure that we get that text box equal A27. Equal A28. Same thing here. Glad it's not 15 customers. Equal A29. And then here, equal A30. Beautiful. All right, now check this out. We can actually hide those intervening rows. Format row hide. And now we have a nice little bit of SmartArt that responds to choosing the filter. So if I choose all and click OK, and now I have the top five customers for all. Now this is even better in Excel 2010 when these various report filters get replaced by slicers. So I have some Excel 2010 slicers up here. Let's actually hide the report filters, format row hide, and now I can just simply choose from the slicers. So let's see, communications, top five customers, AT&T, Verizon, SBC. Choose a particular year and a pair of quarters, and maybe I want communications and financial both. Every time I update the slicers, the SmartArt down here updates to show me those top five customers. So, even if you have a manager who is a big pivot table fan, I bet he's never had a pivot table that looks like this. Using SmartArt, converting to shapes, and then adding formulas to make those shapes dynamic. A very cool way to go. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.